third grade warriors. Welcome back to school. It is a little different, of course. Here I am, Mrs. Adams, in our regular art classroom. I cannot wait for us to be back together in my art classroom eventually, but for right now, at least we get to touch base a couple times each week and draw together. If you hear that noise that just came on, that's my loud air conditioner. I'm in class just like usual. You guys know that air conditioner is loud. So just ignore it, you'll get used to it. For those of you who are new to Western Oaks, I'm Mrs. Adams, I'll be your art teacher. And for the next 9 weeks, two times a week, you guys are gonna follow along with me and you're gonna draw with me for your art specials. Very important, after every lesson, you're gonna take a picture and you're gonna upload it to your Google Classroom under this art folder so I can see what you're doing. Guys, you're gonna get a grade in art for this 9 weeks, and so I really need to see your work every single time. Okay, so we'll talk more about that later. So today we are going to go ahead. You have some blank paper that you got in your packet. I want you to get one piece out and we're gonna draw together on this one piece. Friends, I only had enough paper for everybody, one piece of paper per project. So don't use up all your paper this first week trying to get the perfect sunflower. Remember, third graders, there's no such thing as perfect in drawing and art. So please don't worry about it, do your best. I'm guessing a lot of you haven't been drawing a lot over the summer break, that's okay. We're gonna kind of start simple, do this simple drawing. Do not worry if it's perfect. Guess what? Mrs. Adams' art is never perfect either, so don't worry about it, okay? Just try your best. You have at least a pencil at home that we sent home with you in your packets. Yes, third graders, you can use a pencil to draw, but what I ask of you, please don't get into the habit of erasing every mark you make to try to get it perfect, okay? You know me, no pencils in art class usually, so I don't want you to get in the habit of erasing every single time you make a mark, okay? Just do your best. Try really hard not to even erase and just follow along with me. For those of you who are new, each week you're gonna follow along with Mrs. Adams, and I want you to know that we are gonna remember there's no such thing as good or bad, right or wrong, so don't be nervous, just give it a shot, okay? So here we go. We're gonna start with, like I said, sort of a simpler drawing. We're gonna get back into the swing of things in art class. So we're gonna start with a sunflower. I'm guessing a lot of you have seen sunflowers before. They're all over Oklahoma. So you know that they have yellow petals, the brown centers, those flowers. We're gonna go ahead and start with our paper vertical, up and down tall. Sunflowers can get very, very, very tall. So I want you to have your paper tall. We are gonna start probably not right in the center. I want you to move it up just a little bit to show a little bit longer stem, to show the idea that it's a nice tall flower. All we're gonna do, third graders, is start with just a little tiny dot for the center part of the sunflower. Simple enough. Now, the center of the sunflower is very rough and bumpy. There's texture. You guys have all heard that word a lot of times in Mrs. Adams' art class. We wanna make it look rough and bumpy, so we're gonna make textured lines. We're not gonna make smooth lines, because if you feel it, it's not smooth, it's rough and bumpy. So we wanna make it look that way. So around this little tiny dot that you started with, we're just gonna make a rough, bumpy, little broken circle, not perfect, nice and textured. Around that very center dot, I'm just gonna make some little curve lines here and there. You might have 4 or 5, you might have 50, who knows? You can just fill this space in with some little curve lines just kind of going around. Now, I'm gonna show the outside part of that center of the sunflower. We're gonna show this outside circle to decide how big your center is gonna be. If you make it this big, you're not gonna have much room for petals. Something to keep in mind, you might wanna make it a little smaller. So I'm just gonna go ahead and make a circle with that rough, bumpy, broken, textured line all the way around. If it's not a perfect circle, guess what? Mrs. Adams isn't either, no big deal. Now, you guys have probably seen the center of sunflowers. They're very rough and bumpy, lots of texture there. So I'm gonna go ahead and add some little circles and little curve lines, just little, guys, the really and truly, not making perfect little polka dots is actually gonna make it look more realistic. So you can have some sort of half circles, some curve lines, just some circles and bumps here and there And here's where it kind of is handy, guys. If you want to go super detailed and add tons of detail on your own, you can pause this video. Can't pause Mrs. Adams during class, but you can pause the video. So if you want to take your time and add lots and lots of detail, now's the time. If you want to go ahead and just follow along with me, here's a little artist trick. As you can see on my drawing here, not every centimeter is covered in texture. I left some spots open. That kind of makes it look even a little bit more realistic because it sort of looks like the sun is shining on it. Maybe there's a little bit of highlight to it. So you don't have to cover all of it. It kind of tricks the viewer by adding little clusters here and there. It gives the viewer, whoever's looking at your sunflower, the idea that it is obviously covered in texture, but you don't have to do every single spot, okay? And look, third graders, this is something I want you guys to realize. The more lines, the more texture that I put together, like in clusters, that area looks darker. It looks like it's in shadow. And the fewer, it looks like it's brighter, like it's a highlight, okay? So just think about that. So maybe on the bottom part, I want to add a whole lot more just to make it look more realistic, like it's sort of in that shadow, okay? Now, I know third graders have probably drawn a flower before a million times. If you do not want to follow me for the petals, you can do your own petals, that's fine. If you are kind of getting back in the swing of things and you want to follow along, go ahead and follow along, guys. We're going to start at the top, and I'm going to make the first curve line for my petal, just kind of going straight up. Now look, sunflower petals are just a little bit skinnier on the end, okay? It's not just a perfectly round up and down curve line like that. They get a little skinnier on the end, so I'm just going to make it curve up however long you want your petal to be. Then I'm going to make it a little skinnier at the end by just making a tiny little curve line down, pretty skinny. And I'm going to bring it back in and touch. Same thing over here, curve line out. It's going to be a little skinnier on the end. Bring it back in and touch. Now you guys might be getting the hang of it. Go ahead and fill in your petals. If you want to follow along with me, you can certainly do so. I'm just going to make it out. Skinnier on the end, back in and touch, and I'm just going to do that all the way around. Now look, friends, I am not making perfect curve lines on every single one. See how they're a little bit different? Those little differences in the petals make it even more realistic. So if your petals are not exactly the same, that's actually going to be more realistic. So some might be a little skinnier, some might be a little longer, some might be a little shorter. You just go ahead and fill all the way around. Just gonna follow it all the way around. Now, you guys are in third grade, you need to have a little bit more detail. So I'm gonna go ahead, once I've got my petals, we're gonna make another layer of petals. There is some overlapping. You've heard that word with me before. It's when you don't see, like if my arm is here and this arm kind of covers it, this part is being overlapped, you don't see the whole part of this arm, right? So we're gonna show some petals on another row that's behind it that you don't see all of it, you just see a little bit of them poking out. So in between here, I'm gonna go ahead and add some more petals sticking out by not starting at the, of course, we don't wanna draw right on top of what we have. We wanna stop and jump over and just draw the tips. And I'm just gonna show some tips sticking out. Not perfect. I want them all just a little different. That, my third grade friends, is what's going to make it look much more realistic. We also can add some lines to show there are little skinny lines on the petals of the sunflower. So I can come on here and make just some lines. You could add two or three little lines coming out the center. And look, some might be kind of doubled to make it look thicker. Some might be the same. You just add however many lines you want to each petal, especially on that front row. If you want to show a few poking out on that second row, you could definitely do that just here and there. But see, the sort of the less perfect it is, the more realistic it's going to look, okay? Now for the stem, I want you to think about where you're going to start the stem. The stem is very long, so we're going to just drop right off the page. However much room you have on the bottom, no big deal. Don't try to like scrunch in a stem on like a very short. If you don't have much room, just draw two lines right off the page. Don't try to like scrunch in a couple leaves and really tiny to make them fit, okay? Just draw the lines right off But if you have a little bit of room like I do, we're gonna start the stem. I want you to look at the middle. We don't wanna start the stem over here, guys. The stem's not coming out of the petals. Look at the middle of the flower. I'm gonna stop, jump over those petals, and I'm just gonna start with one, two lines down. Now, for the leaves, we're gonna make the leaves not just perfectly sticking off the sides. We wanna kind of make them look like they're really stuck on the stem, they're growing from the stem. So to do that, on one side, I'm gonna go ahead and just cut right across this line. Wherever you stopped this line, I'm gonna make a slanted line that cuts right across and touches it. One, two short, skinny, straight lines. That's where that leaf is stuck onto the stem. On that bottom straight line that you just did, I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of make a curve line. You can make it real droopy down, you can make it curve over, you can make it stick up, however you want. Whatever you want your leaf to do, we're just gonna make it curve. On this top straight line, I'm gonna go ahead. Now look, I'm gonna make this a little taller because see how the leaf is thicker? And then as it gets to the end, it gets skinnier. So on the top, I'm gonna make it come up more to make that thicker part of the leaf. And then I'm gonna swing it down and make it touch. Now look, mine doesn't touch, so I need to make this a little longer. No big deal. And then we're gonna draw the veins. I'm not going to make just a straight line because this leaf isn't straight. That would make sense to just make it straight over and across. We're gonna follow the curve that's already there. I'm gonna make that center line just following the curve. And then I can make the veins coming off, just kind of slanted curve lines. Let's see, I have room for like five. You might have room for two. It doesn't matter. This is what's really gonna make the leaf look like it's growing from the stem. I'm gonna look at this line that we started. I'm gonna stop, jump over, make it a little longer. So now it really looks like it's stuck on, like it's a part of the stem. Let's see, I have room. You might be out of room. Just go ahead and make the stem right off the page. I have some room, so I'm gonna draw one more leaf. So let's see, I'm gonna go ahead and go on this side, make it a little longer so the leaf is a little lower. I'm gonna do the same thing, just going this way this time. I'm gonna look at this line. I'm gonna make a line that kind of slants right across it. A short little line and skinny next to it, right across. And let's see, my leaf is kind of drooping down. Maybe I want a leaf that sort of sticks more up this time. So I can just kind of make on that bottom. I'm gonna make it come up more. And then we're gonna make it nice and wide at first and then bring it over. Mine don't touch again. Maybe you were lucky and yours touched, but I gotta make this line just a little bit longer so they touch. We're not gonna make it curve down because this leaf is kind of curving more up. We're gonna follow what we already have. We're gonna follow that curve like we already have and then add some of those veins coming off, however many you want, however many you have room for. Okay, so now we've got a floating sunflower. We're gonna make it look like it's really in the ground by just making this line all the way off the paper. Look at this line. We're gonna stop, jump over all the way off the paper. At this point, guys, is where you need to, you could color. I know that you all have crayons. They were given to you in your packets to take home. Guys, we did the best we could with crayons. Not everybody could get a full set, of course. We just kind of gathered what Mrs. Adams had and handed them out. So you might not have brown for the center and yellow for the petals. That is fine. I want you to still color. And we'll talk more about coloring techniques later, but you guys are in third grade. You know how to color solid. I want you to color solid. I want you to remember it's okay if you don't have the exact colors you need for a project. I will never count that against you. We're all just doing the best we can. So if you have an orange and pink and purple sunflower, great. It's an abstract sunflower. You know Miss Adams loves abstract. So you can make it any colors you want. Some of you might be lucky and you might have paints at home or colored pencils at home or markers at home. Use them. That's fine with me. That is A-okay. But what I want you guys to know over the next 9 weeks is you need to take a picture of your drawing so that I see that you're following along and we're learning together our art vocabulary and everything. If you cannot color it in because maybe crayons are at mom's house and you're at daycare and you got to get it done, that's fine. Do the best you can. But I need to see your drawing every single time. So you take a picture and you put that link, you copy that picture and put it on Google Classroom where there's a folder. And if you guys ever have any questions about anything, I am on my office hours are 8:30 in the morning till 9:30 in the morning. You can jump on my Google Meet, you'll get that link, and we can talk and I'll show you how to do anything. If you have any questions about a drawing, I'm always here to answer questions. But I just need you to remember, it's okay if you cannot color it in exactly how you want. And guess what? When we're all back together again, which I can't wait for us to all be back together again, you can bring in your drawing and color at school with me if you'd like, okay? So please don't worry if it's not exactly the colors you want. We're just doing our best. It was so fun to touch base with you guys today. I'm gonna love getting to draw with you a couple times a week. I miss you guys. I love you guys. I hope you're well, and I'll see you soon. Bye, guys.